Hey everyone, we are here to unbox the Galaxy S20
and the Galaxy S20 Plus,
but with a twist. Unlike what we normally do, we are filming this whole video on our Galaxy S20 Ultra in 8K. Okay, so we kind of wanted to find something different to do with this unboxing. We were racking our brains and then we thought we still have our Ultra around. It's going back to Samsung right after this video, basically. But we have the time to film it in 8K and see how it holds up. So this is a bit of a combined S20, S20 Plus unboxing and Ultra 8K video test.
Yeah, so whichever element you want to focus on, you can focus on that. You
exactly.
can focus on what's in these boxes or how it looks.
Yep, and one note, yeah, we are like playing around. Our cameraman is not used to filming on a phone with a gimbal. So if camera angles start going wild and skewy, you can blame him. All right, let's go.
Let's go. So you have the regular S20, I have the Plus model, like I said,
I got the little
start.
One.
Speaking of little, what are the screen sizes we're working with here?
This is a whopping 6.2 inches, so not that little.
Yeah, so not really a thing anymore in phones. And I think this is a 6.7 inch panel,
that
if I'm not mistaken. And then the Ultra, which
6.
We are filming 6.9, which is a bit of a beast.
Okay, so I have, I'm not thrilled to say, the boring grey. Cosmic grey officially, but boring grey.
I have the cosmic black, which I actually quite like. I know black is the most boring phone colour out there, but every manufacturer basically has to make a black version of the phone because they're the ones that usually sell the best.
Yeah, black does sell. I get that. Black, I get grey on all.
Yeah, I'm not sure about this one.
There's also blue and pink, and even a red one in some places.
I really want the red
one. The red looks cool.
But it's not here.
Yeah, it will depend on which markets you're in. Like in some, I don't know, in the UK, like the small one you can get in blue and pink and grey, but not black. And the Plus you can get in blue and black and grey, but not pink.
We tried to look it up. It
Something
got real
like
confusing. And there's like certain things like 4G and 5G might play into it as well, depending on the market.
It's definitely going to be different where you are anyway.
Do your research in case you want a phone in a colour that it can't come in. This one doesn't have any. There's
oh yeah, there's
in,
kind of
in the lid.
Inside the lid, if you think you're missing your instructions or whatever.
Yeah, there is some paperwork in there. I'm not going to worry about the paperwork. There is a SIM tool on the back as well, which is, I mean, useful because otherwise.
And there won't be a case in there. I know some people ship a free case. Samsung doesn't.
Typically, no. That's
there is
not
a
happened.
Screen protector pre-applied to the phone, but that's all you get.
Yeah.
We showed the same setup here. So
yes.
We both got a super fast charging UK power brick. I know everyone in the comments, it looks weird, it's not like the US one, it's not like the European one, it's odd, don't blame us. it's super fast charging, it's worth noting, it's a 25 watt charger, so that's what these phones do. The Ultra can go a bit faster, though actually gets the same charger in the box anyway.
Yeah, it is, I think, C to C as well.
Yeah, C to C on the
Important button. To note.
Yeah, 25 watt fast charging and you get 15 watt wireless charging.
Yes, that sounds about right.
And then headphones, right?
Yeah, this is just a bit, I think there might be an adapter in here in some people's retail packages, it feels like there would be.
Yeah. But yeah, there's definitely space for something.
Space for
that
something.
We don't have. Extra free cardboard.
Hey, perfect.
And then...
Yeah, there's that C to C.
Cable.
Yeah.
Yeah, I went and unpacked mine.
And then yes. It says on this little bit of card as well, sound by AKG. Samsung bought AKG a few years back.
Yeah.
They've now been basically doubling down on that partnership. You'll also see it in the Samsung Home Mini or whatever their home speaker's called.
Is that ever coming out?
If it ever comes out. We've seen, I think, an image or two of it because they're just like, oh, and the headphones, A, it's a braided cord, which is quite nice.
Oh, yeah.
Obviously USB-C because there's no headphone jack on these phones.
Nope, none at all. It's gone.
Yeah.
Dead.
inline remote as well, and you get two additional sizes of ear tips, really large and I think extra small. No, medium and large, and these are the smalls already on there by the looks of it. So you get three sets to choose from, basically.
Which isn't bad for freebies.
No, not bad at all.
And if you pre-order the Plus, you've got the Galaxy Buds Plus anyway.
Exactly, which you've been wearing as
They're
well,
great.
Haven't you?
Yeah,
you love them a lot. Cool. So,
all right, I'm going to turn this phone on.
I'm going to just do this. I'm sure that's fine.
Yeah, no. Sounded great to the viewers, no doubt.
Oh, well.
Okay, so this is the S20 5G. So worth noting, all of these phones come with 5G support depending on the market. So say in the UK, you can get a 4G model of the regular S20, but not the other ones.
And that nabs you £100 less on the price tag, which is important to note.
I know in the US, I've been told it's all 5G. There's just no 4G SKU on any of them.
Yeah.
And then I think, like, say, in India, I think they're all 4G.
Oh, really?
And I think there's probably a 5G option as well, I'm not sure, but I think you can buy any of them in 4G.
And this is where that whole colour thing comes into play, because, like, colours might vary
SKUs
by
get
that.
Messy. Yeah. Storage and RAM varies a bit. Like, I think on this it's 8GB RAM on the 4G, but 12GB on the 5G. It's a mess, so just double-check the one you're buying, what RAM, what storage, what colour, what, like, connectivity, because they do vary.
Yeah. In the UK, I will say, we have a pretty simple setup. So I think, Dom, the regular S20 has 4G or 5G
yep.
with 8 gigs of RAM. 12 gigs on the 5G.
I think it's 12 gig in the 5G.
And maybe 8 gigs on the 4G, that's right. Whereas the Plus comes with just 12 gigs, 5G. That's that. That's your option. I'm going to skip Wi-Fi and all that stuff.
I'm skipping everything I can skip.
Yeah, we're just jumping through the setup process right now. There's nothing really to see here.
All right, I'm in. I beat you. Ha. Cool. There we go. The little Samsung boobity boop boop.
Boobity boop boop.
Yeah, this is the regular S20. I'm a big fan of this one. When I saw the three phones in the first place, my hot take was the S20 is the best of the bunch.
What?
It's a really nice size. I think that's a comfortable size. It still feels like a big phone, but it fits nicely in one hand.
The hand feel looks really good.
I can actually reach everywhere without moving my hand in odd directions. And it still basically has all the same features as the other ones.
I mean, when you said it, I was kind of in agreement. Like, this doesn't feel too bad because the aspect ratio means it's quite a narrow body. So even though it's got a huge display, it's still fairly narrow in the hand. So yeah, that one-handed usage isn't impossible.
Yeah.
You can see there. I think I personally, if I was buying one, would go for the smaller S20. But if you've got slightly larger hands or you just like a bigger screen, this is still manageable in one hand. And Samsung's One UI version 2, I think it is, user interface, does also integrate a one-handed mode as well. So you have that option too.
So let's run down the core differences just between these two, because that's the quick thing. There are very few differences.
Yeah.
The size we've already covered.
Yeah.
The regular one is a bit smaller. It's 6.2-inch screen versus 6.7.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, all the other dimensions change a bit with that. Battery capacity changes because there's space for bigger batteries.
Yep.
So my 120 has a 4,000 mAh battery.
Yeah, and this is 4,500, so just a little bit more. Probably not going to notice it because you're really powering a bigger panel.
Exactly.
It'll same be resolution, though.
And same panel, same refresh rate.
Yep.
They both have 120 hertz.
Yep.
If anything, the panel in the 20 might end up looking better because it's smaller, so that same resolution
sharper.
Is denser, sharper. That also means because you can't run 120 hertz and high res at the same time, you have to drop down to regular HD, that will be less annoying on the S20 because that regular HD will look more crisp than it does on the bigger phones.
All the more reason why it seems to be the better choice.
It is the best one. You're saving £100, $100.
And you're saving £100 to £200 if you're in the UK and you don't need that 5G.
Exactly. The other difference is cameras. So we'll talk about the camera spec, but first, the one difference between the two is this one somewhere, oh, there it is. Has a time-of-flight sensor.
It looks like a fourth lens, like it's going to do something more dramatic than that, but it's just a depth sensor. I think it's 0.3 megapixels. Wow,
That, if you don't know, that's basically going to be used for portrait-y stuff. So it means, in theory, the live focus portrait mode should be a bit better on that.
Yeah, and like if you do live focus in video, which is something that Samsung introduced with the Note range, I believe it was, Note 10 last year, it should be maybe quicker or better. We are yet to test that, obviously, because we've just taken them out of the box.
And I guess it helps with some AR stuff you do with the rear lenses.
Sure,
if you use that.
If that's in there, but like,
there's not a lot to it.
Which is why it's not that much of a deal.
Yeah.
Which is nice to know.
Other camera stuff while we're on cameras, let's just do cameras. So the main lens on both is 12 megapixels, which may sound kind of low compared to the 108 on the Ultra. And I guess in that sense it is low, I can't get away from that. But it's the same as what was on the S10 last year. That was a 12 megapixel main camera. And actually it's not all the megapixels, it's how you use them.
And it's the same image processing and some of the stuff we've seen, especially like the night mode looks greatly improved. There's a whole host of software side improvements as well that I think are going to mean this 12 meg camera is a bit better than the S10 series.
I would expect so.
And yeah.
Then wide angle, I think also 12 meg?
Yes, 12, 12.
So again, that's very similar to last year, 12 megapixel wide angle, not a huge jump. So the jump then is in lens number 3, the telephoto, which is 64 megapixels.
Samsung's own sensor. It's very interesting how they're approaching this telephoto because it's not like the telephoto on the Ultra.
Because even on the Ultra has a 48 megapixel telephoto, but it's a...
Transverse, for a start. It's periscopic.
Yeah, it's a proper periscopic. They've like laid it sideways so it can like fit in the phone and all that kind of stuff. Yeah.
This is not. Which means you do get a smaller camera bump, which is a win on both phones. But the other difference being that, the Samsung's calling it 3x hybrid optical.
Yeah.
Which in my head tells me it's probably 2x optical with...
And then just using the high megapixel count to make up the difference.
Exactly, to get more detail into those shots, those video footage and all of that stuff. So yeah, so in terms of the zoom, it's probably actually 2x optical with that.
Which isn't anything
hybrid.
Special, really.
Yeah. And then it's 30x full digital if you want to go all the way to the end. So you can zoom up to 30x, whereas the Ultra goes up to 100, which is the thing.
Let's see, how can I... Yeah, I've got 30x.
Cool. I've also just jumped into the video options.
Oh, yeah.
because obviously we are shooting this in 8K, so hopefully we look beautifully crisp and wonderful.
If you've got an 8K screen to watch on.
That, yeah, if you've got the right hardware for it, obviously. All of the S20 phones support 8K, which is nice.
Yep.
So that is because of the either Exynos 990 or the Snapdragon 865, mm-hmm. and the amount of RAM available just means that's possible now, which is pretty cool.
Plus that high megapixel sensor, I'm sure, is what's playing a part.
No doubt helping, yeah. And also we did learn that unlike previous phones where high-res clips are limited by, like, time.
Yep.
Samsung's limiting it by file size.
So it should be that, give or take, 5 minutes of footage, which we're probably a bit out, or a bit past, I'm not sure, I've lost track. 5 minutes of footage should be about 4 gigabytes, and at that point it is meant to create a second file. We've not actually filmed this much in 8K before, so we're going to find out when we sit down to edit this.
See if our computer can even handle it, otherwise,
But that is the principle, and all of these phones are capable of doing that. I don't really see the point other than doing silly stuff like this.
Yeah,
camera-wise, I'm very curious to see how these hold up. I wasn't blown away by the Ultra, which obviously is the highest spec camera setup of the lot. That's partly down to software stuff. There were some issues pre-launch. Samsung fixed some of them, but not all of them. I liked a lot of what the Ultra did, but didn't love everything.
There might be some physics going into that with the physical size of that 108 meg
that
sensor.
That huge sensor they had was just bad at close-ups, and you can't get around that.
So by having the 12 as a main, you might have a much more versatile camera in these devices than that one, potentially.
And that's exactly what I think it's going to be.
Yeah.
I think these will be better all-round cameras.
Which is what the Galaxy S range should always be each year, really.
And I think the Ultra will be better for landscapes and for taking shots of things really, really far away.
Mm-hmm.
But if you just want something that will do everything you want to throw at it, and more importantly, will take great Instagram shots of your lunch, I think these are going to do better.
Another thing you mentioned on the Ultra, which is slightly different, these two phones share a 10 meg front facer.
Yeah, yeah, that's a good point.
You were impressed with the selfie camera on the Ultra. I've been intrigued to see how this hole punch camera in the middle here.
So on the Ultra, it's a 40 meg.
So yeah, and you said it was really good. Probably the best selfie camera you'd used, right?
As someone who does not like selfies,
sure.
I took photos of myself I liked on that phone.
Well, that's
very
high praise
for me.
It
broke through my own self-esteem issues
through the sheer power of megapixels. So yeah, this 10 meg sensor would be intriguing to see how closely it compares to the Ultra in terms of just image processing and if there's any other kind of secret behind the scenes tricks they're doing to kind of get them more consistent between the S20 range, as it were.
And then the last worry I have from using the Ultra, again, is battery life. I had okay but not great battery life with the Ultra, which has a bigger battery cell at 5,000. So these are smaller batteries, but they are smaller screens. They've got a bit less to power. But with that 120 hours refresh rate, still Exynos processors for us.
Yeah.
Oh, camera did a wobble.
I'm
a little bit worried the battery life, especially on the regular S20, might struggle, but we're going to see.
Yeah.
I can see our gimbal is struggling, so we are going to have to wrap it up now. These are S20 and the 20 Plus. My pick, I think Tolly's pick as well, is the 20 looks like the best one. But I know some of you are going to disagree. Jump in the comments, let us know.
Thanks for watching.